The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 227 pounds, he is one half of the World Tag Team Champions, Chris Jericho!
This guy's hot, red hot, and he claims to be the king of the world.
And his tag team partner, Christian, did not fare very well earlier tonight against RVD, who will be in the Elimination Chamber at Survivor Series along with Jericho.
His sights set on decimating Triple H here tonight.
I can't believe Kane would come out here with a big fireball and explosion. You'd think he would have learned as a kid that you don't play with matches.
I must admit, it's a little odd to look at these guys as partners here tonight, knowing that in the Elimination Chamber, they are all going to be against each other.
Well, of course, add Rob Van Dam and Shawn Michaels to the mix. It's going to be amazing. I can't wait.
It'll be every man for himself, King, and each and every one of them has one goal in mind, to be the World Heavyweight Champion.
The kick connects. Oh, and the knee connects.
We don't know exactly what to expect when we see the Elimination Chamber unveiled at Survivor Series, but we do know that it will combine elements of War Games, the Royal Rumble, and Survivor Series.
And add to that the importance of the World Heavyweight Championship. Well, I, for one, cannot wait for Survivor Series.
He almost took his head off with that lariat. Drop. What physicality? What strength? Wow, that might have broken his jaw.
Yeah, everybody had a pretty good laugh at the game's expense last week when the Hurricane showed that supposedly funny video of a fake Triple H at the doctor's office. But I'm thinking it's time for payback this week.
Oh, come on, King. That was all in good fun. Now that Katie Vick video that Triple H made was just plain disgusting.
I thought it was awesome.
A textbook suplex. And there it is. The big boot connects.
His weight on that leg drop.
He was one step ahead on that one.
Kane with a reversal.
Wow, I am really impressed with Kane's quickness here. Nice reversal there. What a boot!
Down goes Jericho.
Well, down but not out, Cole. Mark my words, Jericho's not out.
How much damage did that do?
A lot from the looks of it.
You know, Cole, the more I think about it, the more I like Chris Jericho's chances at Survivor Series. When the title's on the line, Y2J is at his best. And this is the guy who beat The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin on the same night.
It was December of last year at Vengeance. Jericho first beat The Rock to become world champion, then WWE champion Stone Cold to become the first historic undisputed champion.
You know, not only is Chris Jericho one half of the World Tag Team Champions, but he's also a huge rock star.
Well, he says he is. Some people would actually say he's an ass clown.
What? Now, why would you say that, Cole? You're the one acting like an ass clown.
Great move.
Jericho says he's sick of Booker T calling him sucker. And I'm being honest, I agree. He has a name, you know.
Jericho has also said he has more talent in his pinky finger than Booker T has in his whole body, which is obviously a gross misestimation.
Woo, a little showboating going on here.
What a kick that was.
And he reversed it.
Good move there.
And the knuckles connect.
You know, Booker T hasn't gotten the opportunities that many feel he deserves to become the World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, he'll have a huge opportunity inside the Elimination Chamber at Survivor Series.
And you can bet he wants to build momentum heading into Survivor Series. He can do just that right here tonight if he can fend off...
Oh, lights out!
When are you people going to learn to get over stuff? I mean, Triple H does one little thing to Shawn Michaels, and he can't get over. And then Triple H makes one funny little video about Kane, and now Kane's all upset.
Oh, my gosh!
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Monday Night Raw live from Boston, Massachusetts.
And the last time we were here in Beantown was for the 4th of July edition of SmackDown. Boy, were there ever fireworks on that night?
That was the night we crowned new World Tag Team Champions when Edge and his childhood hero Hulk Hogan. Oh, what a devastating move by Kane.
He's setting it up.
Not this!
Oh my, what a move!
Let's not forget, Triple H was awarded the World Heavyweight Championship on September 2nd.
Oh, I'm so sick of you throwing that in Triple H's face. He's defended it numerous times since then. He's beaten everybody in WWE.
Actually, that's not true, Ken. There's a few left. And if you eliminate Ric Flair and a sledgehammer, Triple H wouldn't even be champion today.
What?
Work is being put in by Booker T. He was able to reverse and get out of that. Look at him out there, reaching for the tag. He can't wait to get back in the mix.
Jericho and Triple H are partners here tonight, but you have to wonder how much longer these guys can coexist. Earlier this year, at WrestleMania 18, it was the game-beating Y2J for the Undisputed title.
Well, let me just say this. I actually wonder how long Booker T and Kane are going to coexist. They're both going to be in the Elimination Chamber, and they're both a couple of freaks.
Booker T and Kane have some integrity. I think they're going to be just fine. It's the guys across the ring from them that I'm a little suspect about.
Integrity? You know, we may be getting ahead of ourselves with all this Shawn Michaels talk, Cole. He still has
an astonishing maneuver by Booker T.
You know, I'm actually glad Nate is at ringside. If Triple H is worried about Shawn Michaels, he can stop. Flair will take care of it.
I'd say Shawn Michaels is firmly in the mind of Triple H and Ric Flair, and quite frankly, probably Y2J too.
Well, don't stop there, Cole. All five of Michaels' opponents at Survivor Series have to keep him in their mind. If healthy, he can very well walk away with a goal at Survivor Series.
And Triple H with a reversal.
And that's because the game has a gift for getting out of trouble, Cole.
Oh! He's got him hooked!
And he gets back in the ring.
Oh, boy, did he get dropped or what?
He wants back in this match in the worst way.
Booker zeroing in again.
Another huge, destructive scissors kick. He's
Well, look at this.
covered by Booker!
And saving the matchup was Chris Jericho. And Chris Jericho looking for the walls at Booker T.
Oh, look out!
Top rope Kane! 300 plus pounds, flooring Chris Jericho. And now he takes the fight, kicking Jericho outside.
Watch out here. Oh my gosh, Kane into those steel steps.
Meanwhile, Booker T and Triple H. Booker T knocking the official off the apron. And now Booker T with a big kick.
That could do it. Triple H flattened by that big kick from Booker T. What's Booker doing now?
Well, Booker usually doesn't go up top. Booker T is Triple H. Stepped out of the way. And now Triple H is going to take advantage. Right to the midsection.
Oh, boy. Looking
for the pedigree now. On Booker T. Wait a minute. Shawn Michaels
with sweet chin music.
Dropping Triple H. The official down and out. You never saw it.
The showstopper putting the referee back in the ring. Shawn Michaels just stopped the show for Triple H. Shawn Michaels with the sweet chin music on Triple H, and all Booker T has to do now is cover the game.
Bischoff invited me to be a part of Survivor Series, to be a part of the Elimination Chamber match, to have a chance at the World Heavyweight Championship. Decisions, decisions, decisions. Well, the answer is... yes!
Oh, yes! Yes!
And Triple H, I can assure you, I'm walking out of the garden, walking out of that chamber match, the new World Heavyweight Champion!
Shawn Michaels is in, and he's coming to be the world's champion at Survivor Series!
With Shawn Michaels stamping his name as the final competitor in the first ever Elimination Chamber, the main event at Survivor Series was set. Six Raw superstars would battle for the World Heavyweight Championship, held by Triple H. Taking place inside the 16-foot-high unpredictable structure, weighing 10 tons of pure pain.
In the past 3 months, I had beaten everybody that was placed before me, gone through every obstacle. But was it good enough? No, it wasn't. Tonight, inside of 10 tons of steel, I will go up against five of the very best ever. I will walk out still the World Heavyweight Champion.